हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल इंडस्ट्रियल गुरुजी। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल। मेनी ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स कीप आस्किंग मी अबाउट फिलेट वेल्ड टर्मिनोलॉजीज एंड देयर रिलेशंस। सो द टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर टुडे इज फिलेट वेल्ड टर्मिनोलॉजी, दैट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू सीसीप 3.1 वेल्डिंग इंस्पेक्टर बुक। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग वीडियो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर न्यू देन प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल एंड हिट बेल आइकॉन फॉर वीडियो अपडेट्स। फ्रेंड्स, फिलेट वेल्ड इज अ फ्यूजन वेल्ड विच इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली ट्रैंगुलर इन क्रॉस सेक्शन। फिलेट वेल्ड्स रेफर्स टू अ प्रोसेस ऑफ जॉइनिंग टू पीसेस ऑफ मेटल टूगेदर वेन दे आर परपेंडिकुलर और एट राइट एंगल्स। इन दिस फिगर टर्मिनोलॉजीज रिगार्डिंग फिलेट वेल्ड आर शोन। दीज आर क्वाइट फैमिलियर टू अस, बट हियर टू टर्म्स आर न्यू, दैट आर फ्यूजन लाइन एंड वेल्ड जोन। फ्यूजन लाइन इज अ लाइन बिटवीन बेस मेटल एंड वेल्ड मेटल, एंड वेल्ड जोन is the area containing HZ and weld metal. Now, unlike butt welds, fillet welds can be defined using several dimensions. So, let's see them one by one. The first dimension we are going to see is a leg length. Leg length is defined as the opposite and adjacent faces of a fillet weld. Here, vertical distance from root to toe is called as vertical leg length, and horizontal distance from root to toe is called as horizontal leg length. Leg length is very important dimension, as according to AWS it is referred as fillet size. Means the dimension on drawing given as fillet size is nothing but its leg length. The arrows are pointing towards the toes of a weld. Regarding toes, there is a famous quote in welding as toes of a weld should be smoothly blended. This is done to avoid stress concentration. The second dimension in fillet weld is throat thickness. Throat is defined as the distance from root of a weld to center of a face. Here, two throat thicknesses are shown. A stands for design throat thickness. It is a minimum dimension used for design purpose. It is also called as effective throat thickness. Here, B stands for actual throat thickness. It is actual dimension we get while welding. Throat is also an important dimension, as in European standards it is referred as fillet size on drawing. Now, for deep penetration fillet welds, design and actual throat thicknesses are considered from fusion point to face as shown here. Here, to differentiate the type of a weld from previous one, the throat thickness is symbolized as S instead of A. Now, there are three fillet weld profiles. First is mitre fillet weld. Here, the cross section area of this type of a weld is right angle isosceles triangle. Here, design throat thickness and actual throat thicknesses are same. Second is convex fillet weld. Since there is excess weld metal, the actual throat thickness is bigger than the design throat thickness. And the third one is concave fillet weld. Here, in this type, design throat thickness is similar as actual throat thickness. But due to smooth blending of toes, stress concentration effect is reduced as compared to others. These profiles are preferred for the joint subjected to cyclic loads, where fatigue phenomenon is a major cause of failure. Friends, till now we have seen terms and dimensions regarding to fillet welds. Now we will see the relation between them. First is throat. Many times we know leg length, but throat is unknown to us. Like in the case of drawings, they only show one dimension. So in this case, design throat can be calculated by following formula, as design throat thickness is equal to 0.707 into leg length, that is A is equal to 0.707 into Z. Let's understand this relation with example. Here, leg length given is 14 mm, so the design throat will be 0.707 into 14, that is equal to 9.89, means approximately 10 mm. We'll take another example to understand this better. Here, leg length given is 10 mm, so for design throat calculation we use the above relation as 0.707 into 10, that is 7.07, means approximately 7 mm. Isn't it simple? Similarly, if we know design throat thickness, then we can calculate leg length by following relation. Leg length is equal to 1.41 into design throat thickness. That is, Z is equal to 1.41 into A. Now let's understand this by example. Here, design throat thickness given is 10 mm. So according to our formula, leg length will be 1.41 into 10, that is 14.1, means approximately 14 mm. Let's see second example for better understanding. Here, throat given is 15 mm. So for leg length, we'll use above relation
1.41 into 15,
that is 21.15, means approximately 21 mm. So friends, these are the ways to calculate throat and leg lengths. Hope all of you understood. These are simple and quite famous in welding. Friends, relation between leg length and throat we have seen so far are applicable only to miter and convex fillet welds. The above relation does not applicable to concave fillet welds as their cross section is not isosceles triangle. Till now, we have seen the relation between throat and leg length. If the angle between two members is 90 degree. But what if the angle between members is different? So for that, the following factor with different angles has been given for throat calculation. If the angle between two members is 60 to 90 degree, then factor to be used is 0.7. If the angle is 91 to 100 degree, then the factor to be used is 0.65. If the angle is 101 to 106 degrees, then factor is 0.6. And if the angle is 107 to 113 degrees, then the factor used is 0.55. Lastly, if the angle between two fusion faces, that is members, is 114 to 120 degrees, then factor to be used is 0.5.
Now, we will move towards importance of leg length. Here, as in case of A, both vertical and horizontal legs are equal, that is 4 mm. So the area will be 8 mm square. Now, in case of B, vertical leg is more than horizontal leg. So though the area, that is 8 mm square, remain the same as of A, throat thickness gets altered, reducing considerably the strength of weld B. So throat and leg length plays important role in deciding strength of fillet weld.
So this is all about fillet joint terminology. Hope all of you have understood. These are very simple to understand and fun to learn. The terminologies and formulas which I explained are given in CCIP 3.1 Welding Inspector book. So friends, if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit bell icon for updates. Please comment below on what topic you want my next video. Thank you.